Hey,
Me
what's
too.
up, guys? This is Bogla. I'm back again with another fun, exciting episode of Building with Bogla. We're going with that, I think. I've got a little thumbnail, I think, even. So I'm here with some of the guys from the Discord again. We're all just goofing around, having some fun with these cars, and we've had some shenanigans happening to the point where I couldn't miss it anymore and just had to start recording. And that is part of it, is running over people. So
okay, ready? Ready? All right, I'm gonna fall on the ground. You run over me. Ready?
I didn't even finish loading
go,
my
go, go.
Base yet.
Yes.
Wait, you gotta wait. No, you gotta like get out of the car. To me, you're still in the car.
No. I'm stuck inside of his hood again.
I see his car moving, but your head is through the ground. Like, what is this? Is the shenanigans that I could not miss anymore? Like, your car is bucking right now
it's
to nothing.
Lowrider.
There is nothing there, and you're just jumping.
It's a new lowrider.
You got a trike going on. Wait, let me see if I jump on this. What happens? Wait, are you in the hood still? Are you under his
yes,
car?
I'm still on the hood. I'm still in the hood. This isn't fair. I didn't sign up for this.
Oh, okay.
I'm still. No. I can do it again. Okay, ready? 3, 2, 1. Okay, I'm on the ground. No, do it. Yes, perfect.
Oh, my
Yay.
Goodness. So in this episode, you guys have started to hear rumors and seen my other videos just kind of hinting at the fact that I am building a glass cannon floor. Well, this is going to be a little bit of a reveal on it and kind of the showings and a little bit of a how-to as to some of it.
It's the other day, Valentine, I ran over you.
Where are you? I don't even see you anymore. You're still sitting in the seat. How did that just happen? What? Okay. My server is catching up right now. I think I've just been lagging so much. I think that's been my biggest problem.
Bogla's logic.
What? I'm not even touching anything, and I'm just jumping around.
You're halfway inside of my car.
What? It
this
just
isn't fair.
It just loaded, gave me a vehicle. What? I'm getting hurt. How am I getting hurt? Like, what is... Oh, my goodness.
Okay, well, now you get to be in the car. I found one.
I am so glad I'm recording this. This is crazy. I don't even know what's going on anymore. I go from loading to it can't find my property to me jumping all over the place and almost dying and inside of your car all of a sudden.
Hey, Bogla,
yeah. Come here. Oh, boy.
Okay, so get in the passenger seat of this over here. Get over
right.
here. I'm in this
Let me load this. Alright, so that was the plan for this episode. We'll see if we can actually get to that. Otherwise, we'll just have some fun with this and have some crazy great times.
Okay, Bogla, you see the flipped over car? Get in the passenger seat, which is what I'm standing above.
Why?
I don't
want to be a part of a hit and run anymore.
No, that's not what I'm showing you. I'm showing you a secret.
Okay, what is this?
No, you have to get in the passenger seat.
Passenger, okay.
Wait, watch this. Let's go over head on.
You see where the grave is? Okay, well, this is not fair. I'm stuck in the back of my truck.
Wait, so you were trying to have me basically pin you to the ground in here?
No, because you know how with the yellow wood, right? Okay, there was where you drop the wood off, right?
Yeah.
Look to where the grave is by Wood R Us.
There's the grass wall in front of the buildings. So right at the front corner of the Woods R Us and the land store, there's a grass wall. But you see a collection bin down there, yeah.
Yeah, like, if you look under, there's a collection
bin. Oh, wait a minute. What?
There's a collection bin, and there's a wood drop-off.
Oh.
What could that be?
I was just looking at this angle. You guys are going to have to watch this video later, but I just saw the rock wall behind the Woods R Us store, and it created the exact shape of, like, the dump bin from the shack out in the snow area. So all of a sudden, I thought there was a bin there that dropped down into it, and I'm like, wait a minute. What can we do? There's something there? Was there an update? I panicked for a second.
You can just sit under there. You know what? Just... Wait, do you see it? Hey, Billy, too?
Yeah. Yeah, I saw it there. Back
okay,
to fun.
I'm not getting stuck in the back of my truck again. This is...
Yeah, so for you guys also, those of you
over,
who
I'm
are...
Ooh,
there was a lot of leg. But those of you who ask a lot of times for some of the bigger people to jump servers and all that sort of stuff, this is just kind of a testament to what it takes for us to jump servers or even just join in general. I mean, on an average day, I take at least about 5 minutes just to get into a server, connect, and start loading. It's probably 10 to 15 before I can actually truly dive in and actually play. So, yeah, once you start getting into a big server or a big base size, it takes a while.
That's true. Oh, look at this drive.
Do you want to see my lighting system for my shop that I was going to show you earlier?
Yeah, we can take a look at that. But I am actually witnessing some driverless car wars.
No, it's a carception.
Some ghost car wars? I don't know. Whoa! I don't know what to call this right now. But hey, can we flip the small car over, whitelist me, so I can drive it, and we can all have some crazy little car wars while I'm waiting for my base to load?
Mm-hmm. Reloading your base.
What the? I just went from the small car to inside of this car. Oh, please connect, please. Oh, please, maybe.
Okay, you ready? I'm gonna hit you now.
Come on. You can do it. For some reason, this server seems like it's got a lot of lag.
I'm trying to help you here.
Upside down boat rider.
Oh, whoa, wait. Bogla.
Your base is loading.
It is for right now. We'll see how long it takes, though.
Come here and get in the driver's seat of this car. I have to show you another secret.
I'm kind of pinned. I'm trapped.
Once you're unpinned,
well, if all of you guys go to the back end of the car.
I'm like, you're gonna kill me soon. Who's ever car this is, you're gonna kill me soon.
There we go.
I helped you.
Michael, come to this small gray car.
Okay.
And get in the driver's seat.
Well, to my eyes, Voiceless is still sitting in it. No, that's in the passenger seat.
No, I'm
seat.
In it.
Oh, okay.
I'm in the passenger, you're in the driver.
Okay.
Okay, now look under again, and look at the box that we saw earlier.
It's not letting me actually get my head under. I don't have one of the old ones. I got one of the new guys, so it's not letting me get my head underneath. Do you want to try getting out?
Yeah.
Let me try.
Hey, Billy, let him do it like that. But look at the box. You know how when it was in the snow biome? What happened was the bin was open.
Mm-hmm.
This bin is closed.
Well, this bin was open before, and then he just put the layer of grass on top of it. This bin always had sides like that.
No, not what I mean by that.
Oh, the collection bin?
Like the actual wood popping to it, like in the snow biome. Huh. There's like the wood with the arrow meter.
Yeah.
How that open? That one right there is closed.
That is so odd. Well, I mean, it's not even that. It's the actual full thing where all he's got to do is just slide it up into the slot, because that bin would take up that space below the collection bin to the actual plate. So
and
he
just move up the floor.
So it's literally another event like the winter stuff, but.
Could it be
for
summer
something
games?
Else? No, because Summer Games is going to be in a couple of years, so I doubt he'd be implementing something now. But could he be doing, holiday festive kind of stuff? Like, maybe a St. Patrick's Day?
A St. Patty's Day, yeah, but what about Easter Day?
Could do something with that. Who knows? We'll have
to... Easter, or maybe it's the 4th of July.
Well, could be, but... I don't know if he would do that. It is mainly a U.S. based game. Oh my goodness, I'm flopping a lot.
Oh, I just forgot I'm recording off my Roblox.
So yes, YouTube. Once again, this is my base. It is still maybe halfway done.
Yeah, do it's I whitelist me? Can you whitelist me?
Oh wait, the lights are coming on. It's almost there. I can't whitelist yet. I don't have a menu. Not until I finish loading.
Bogla, I'm gonna go grab my car from my base, and then I'm gonna show you the lighting system in my shop.
Okay. Yeah,
and I can maybe help you set it up for yours, too.
This server is pretty laggy, so we'll see what we can get to. Otherwise, we're just going to have a bunch of fun today. I'll show you kind of... Wow, that is terribly laggy. You guys are going to watch this video and not even know how I was able to keep track of what's going on, I think.
God dang it, Bogla, I was so close. I thought I had more money than you.
Do you have the menu yet? You have the menu yet?
I do have the menu yet. Let me open the door, though. There we go.
Can you
Bogla, did you ever change the password from when mommy did it?
I have not.
Can you white this to me, please? Before I close the door?
Why? You just leave it open. We're on a private server. Well, there's nobody else that would be worried about stealing my wood. Although I know not all of these trucks are mine. So I'm going to get rid of one or two of them.
Can you white this to me? Actually, that's mine.
Just leaving your trucks all over the place.
Can you let me if I can take it to my base?
Yeah, let me actually get it out of my base, though. Oh, damn. There we go. Oop, that's
Side it right in there.
Let me just go ahead and whitelist you guys all. There you go.
Hi.
You guys steal from me, you guys get banned from the Discord.
Okay.
Alright, so, this is what I have been working on for the last little while now.
I have two trucks, big trucks now.
And a big shout out to those who did donate glass to me. You know who you are. Thank you so very much.
Bogla, I just checked to make sure that you weren't glitching wood. And you're not glitching wood, so good
nope.
job.
Never have.
You probably will, though. Eventually.
No, not on purpose at all.
Yeah.
If I ever have or ever will, it's never on purpose, and it's such small amounts because it's always like one unit pieces that I usually don't notice necessarily. All right, so this is my chopping storage area, my magazine clip that I'm going to call it for my cannon system. The wood will come in all the way up here. Still working on some of the conveyors over there, so don't mind that. The wood will come in over here, and I'll divert it onto this system. So from here, oh yeah, by the way guys, new look. What do you think? Let me know. I know you guys have all been probably freaking out for probably the last 5-10 minutes on it, and I haven't even mentioned it. Sorry. But, so the wood will all come up in here, and throughout this, I'll have a couple of saws, dicing it all up, making it all nice and fine. And I'll keep this gate open, so it just stays on an ever-ending loop, filling up and storing more. When I want to then start to fire, I will come on up over here. And there'll be a wire coming down, and I'll flip this one, and the wood will start to come on up this. I'm thinking about doing a double so I can even do it faster. And then once it gets up to the top here, I am working on my cannons currently, and it'll split off into each direction going out to each cannon. So this is so far the base idea for these cannons. It'll come on out here, it'll come up this little ramp, it'll slide on down the barrel, right onto the back. And depending on how it works, I gotta test this still. Slap a box on this backside here, stick some dynamite inside of the box, run it up to some wires. You flip the switch, you light the dynamite with the wire, and it goes and shoots all the wood right on out of the cannon. Shooting out nice big old chunks, little pieces, all the way out there. So I'm building this for Cannon Wars with Trucker and Saracusa.
So in other words, all you have to do is you just have to build your cannon as high as possible and just the TNT and some little small thing with a ton of small wood.
Oh, you don't even have to actually build it high. There's plenty of them that are right on the ground. And I mean, you just get a nice little spray of wood all the way across the ground. But the higher you go, the further that you can get it to go. I mean, I've had shots that have gone all the way out to the boat and into the water from here. And I know Saracusa, he's building one that's kind of at an angle. So he's got a bit of a crazy design on that, so you guys are going to want to definitely see that later on when we're actually doing the Cannon Wars. And from this spot, aiming at the bridge, he can actually get a couple of pieces all the way across, and he was telling me earlier today, I think, that it was even to the point where the wood forks off to go off into the back prairie area and to the stores over there. So he's got some pretty good distance. So these cannon wars are going to be pretty crazy. I think it's going to come down to who can stay connected to the server longer.
Just like... See who's computer beefy enough to just sit there and like have 20,000 chunks of wood.
I think we're gonna start to put literally the Roblox servers, excuse me, or just the capability of our connectivity to the servers. Because I know we've all got some pretty good beefy computers, but to have 3-4 cannons going at the same time, it's gonna be pretty crazy.
You know, it'd be funny if Deep Felt did an event where he went onto like somebody's base that had the best cannon, and he copy and pasted it onto everybody's like on a save that they don't use, and so he just had every single person join a server, and they had to launch their cannon all at the same time on the Discord server.
He loads you on, gives you a pre-chopped pile of wood, just stick it on, dice it up, and shoot it.
And everybody does it at the same time and see how long Roblox is down for.
And can you imagine, too, because normal servers you only get 6, but can you imagine if he would load literally all 9 because there are 9 slots? So 9 bases of cannons going off at the same time?
I wonder how many people's computers would literally just shut off. You want to try this? There, guess what? No more game for you.
There may be a server melting down somewhere.
Roblox might have one of their systems just kind of just like melting itself.
Alright guys,
I
do quickly want to go over just my general design of this. I know it's night. These don't really show up all too well. So before, a lot of cannons have always been square. Well, I'm actually building a cannon, a full-on tubular cannon. I actually got the designs and the build for the shape of it. I mean, I could have worked it all out, probably would have taken me quite some time, but I had a friend in the Discord who had been playing with it. So I just kind of asked her if she could quick take a look at it. And I believe that was one baby girl who did it for me. And it was pretty awesome. She nailed it in no time. So the way on this one here is actually in the wedges, you do a 2 or a 3 unit gap. So it's just if you go to even just to the posts, that will be 4 units long, but 1 unit wide. So the tiny floors are 1 unit by 1 unit. You guys all probably know that. Probably have seen Code's videos a handful of times. But, so then for the wedges, off of that 3-unit gap for those straight points, you then use a 1x3, I believe is what it was. No, a 1x2. So, you turn this on the side. I'm just doing the short little ones for ease of not building a massive thing. And then you flip them around so that they're like this, and you go the 3 units. Then from there, it was a 2x2 for the big bulk of the turn on both sides. And pro tip of the day, guys, when you're flipping things over, if you're building something like this, it helps if you just quickly remember what buttons you need to get to flip them. So, that's actually the wrong one. Put the wrong size on there. Yes, Dab, shout out to you. You're awesome. And for the server.
This is his server.
That it is. Thank you. Yeah, I actually do not have my own private server at the time. So I've just been kind of looking and playing off of others, doing a lot of public. I usually always do a lot of public anyway. Now remember, too, though, you guys are always building off of the closer center point. So it would be then like this. Oh, I goofed on that one. 2 and 3. And then it would just be repeating the process. Because then you just do another 2x2, and then another 1x2, and then another 3 blocks, and another 2x2, and a 1x2 kind of thing. You just keep going around. Build yourself a circle. And then from on that, on the inside, I just kind of filled it in, made it a little bit neater right around it. For this one, though, I did have to increase the sides to 4 units in here rather than the 3, just to actually fit the conveyor. All right, well, I'm not going to bore you guys with any more of the details and that sort of stuff or getting any of the wood. Just wanted to fill you guys in so you guys see everything that I've got, so this helps you guys build it, design it, and do it yourselves. Gets you guys out there, gets you guys building. I know Mummy's doing a whole thing with zero base to awesome by herself kind of thing with my help on a lot of the logic and figuring things out, and we bounce ideas off each other, which also helps me come up with things. So what do you guys want to do for the rest of this? We got a little bit of time.
Well, I was going to show you a new lighting system that I invented with.
We can definitely do that. I'm only at 21 minutes right now, so we got about another 10 minutes or so. I don't want to use that to go get some wood or do some more building stuff, so.
You can also do an end times run if you really wanted to.
Not in 10 minutes. We could start one.
I've done it in about 8, I think.
Well, yeah, we probably could, actually. I mean, I'll do that probably in another episode, though. All right, where's your base?
It's in the back behind where us.
So by the boat somewhere? Or in that,
In the, like, the cove okay. area by the snow biome.
Excuse there. Me, guys, and pardon the whole nose-navel-sounding talking. I have been feeling under the weather the last couple of days. I've been trying to still do some videos here and there, but...
No. This is the shop right here, and if you do notice, there's quite a cool lighting system in here.
I like the way it kind of looks and lights from outside, even. Nice! I really like that. Did you try doing with the dark blue on those, too?
I just looked at the light blue match the color.
Okay.
I ended up doing the light blue, but I am probably going to try and change to the dark blue.
I was just kind of wondering as to how that would look. Because, I mean, if you do the dark blue and the red at night, it would kind of even give you, like, a purple look.
Well, I have dark blue wires right here, so I'll flip one of them, see how that looks.
Because that could be pretty cool coming off of the white. All of a sudden, it has, like, a black light effect. It makes the white really pop kind of thing.
That would be really cool.
And I like that red. That red does look really nice coming down from the ceiling. Oh, there's a... Okay. I was wondering why that blue looked kind of dulled. And then I realized that you had a pane of glass in front of it. That is cool. I had not thought about using glass like that.
Yeah, because what happens is with the glass pane...
Yeah.
What ends up going through is it ends up like... With the light on it, it kind of think of it as this. If you have a neon wire, like if you have like a neon sign, it kind of changes the perspective of the glass, okay? Mm-hmm. And so what I did with this was I put the wires around the glass so that it kind of like shined in and kind of put a color onto the glass.
Mm-hmm.
In the sense of where...
Well, it's almost like it frosts it too. It kind of fogs it a little bit and dulls the color down a bit. Because I've been working with glass, like as you guys can see, for a while, and I've stared through I don't know how many countless panes of glass, and you just get this foggy kind of look through it. It looks really cool, though. Especially, I didn't think about doing it with blue, though.
Because it was the only color that I found that glowed.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, with the glow, right. I gave it a texture for it.
Alright, where did everybody disappear to? Where did Dab go?
Is he still here? He had to go. It's probably, like, bedtime.
Oh, he said, yeah, assume. And bye. Okay. Well,
So I'm just finishing up the blue wiring right now.
Voice, where did you go?
What you? I'm up still to? In my base.
What you up to?
Just wiring every. I'm just wiring the dark blue. See how that would look right now.
And out. What do you got going on? Yeah, and sorry guys, I did fully intend for this to be some sort of a building episode or getting some more stuff going and whatnot.
I'm sorry that it's not fun, but I'm trying.
But I will definitely get another video out here pretty soon. We definitely had some fun though in the beginning. Come on, that was pretty awesome.
That was fun.
Pinning each other under the ground, another hit and run from Dab.
I really honestly do like that dark blue better than the neon light blue. Mm-hmm.
Did you just take that car and put it into the fold? You just... Oh, no, never mind. I parked on the backside. I forgot where I was.
Do you want to come check out that dark blue?
Yeah. See, at night, though, is when it's really going to pop. You want to come? You want to hop in?
Yeah, I know exactly what you mean.
I'm going to take a look at it. Alright, what do we got? Ooh. Kind of blends in a little too much, I think. You'd have to wait and see what it looks like at night.
Because that's, like, mostly what the lights would be in for. So, I mean, yeah, but it's, like, what you would have to do is you sort of have to have it to where the wires would,
like, I do like kind of like
and the dark blue neon wires.
Yeah, I do kind of like how it blends in a little bit during the day, as long as it would pop enough at night. Because, I mean, when you just kind of walk in, it makes it look like it's highlighted.
Mm-hmm.
But then also it kind of gives me the feel of... It makes that pane of glass painfully obvious that it's there.
Yeah, I see what you mean.
Because it does match so well that it makes the blue even seem a brighter, more obvious blue.
So you can, like, tell the glass pane.
Yeah, so it's like there's clearly something there, and it's not quite perfectly lined up, so yeah.
Oh, and also, did you notice that these stove bins were different? They're in a different design.
What the... How do you have that little gap in here? Is that just a product of placement, or what?
No, that's... So, here, I'll show you what I mean.
No, those are just cabinets. Okay.
No, because look at this, okay? You see this cabinet, right?
Uh-huh.
This is what the cabinets he has now look like. You want to know what the cabinets from 2 years ago look like? That's a comparison to how he changed the cabinets.
Ooh. Yeah, I was not playing that long ago, so... Oh. Mm.
And what I found is if, like, you're making, like, a countertop, so say this is a shop, okay?
So wait a minute, you still have the blueprints from 2 years ago?
Yeah, I do.
And I want some of them.
If that, you that ever, is like, awesome. Need any of them, I could place them down for you.
That is awesome. I have no idea what you even got, though. That's the bigger thing.
Because look at this way. If you put it so that this edge right here...
Where does this open? What? Where do one of these open?
What do you mean by opens?
You said it's a cabinet. Doesn't it have a door, or is it just an open top cabinet?
It's just an open top cabinet. Okay. But this right here doesn't open either.
Yeah. Oh, actually, wait, no. Yeah, those ones don't. The single ones do. Wait, no, these ones... I think they do.
They open?
I think so. Because I know the singles do, because I made, like, a filing cabinet out of mine.
They open? I never knew they opened.
Yeah, they open. I got ball and, I think a lump of coal and a couple of loose eyeballs stuffed in mine.
Just take this piece right there and bring it over.
Okay.
And we'll test it out.
Ah, so much lag. I'm staring at it, and it's not, I can grab it. There it goes.
I did not know that those could open.
Yeah. Yeah, because you can put the countertop on top of it, and you got a nice little actual full-on kitchen that can open.
Okay, we just need one. Well, I'll just go grab a piece. Right. Whatever. Well, this is fun.
Here, you get a loose wire out here. I can pick that up for you. There's one of the nice light blue ones sitting outside your front doors.
Oh. There we go. I just kind of get wood as I go along. I never thought those opened.
Oh yeah.
Like.
Yep.
Wait. Okay, hold on.
Yeah, because then you can put like, because then yeah, you just put like a tile or a countertop up on top of it, and then you have actual working counters, and cabinets. You can hang them up you can put it up on the wall.
Let's measure this.
Oh, yeah, let me.
If I open that, can I?
Yeah, you can fit an eyeball on there.
Oh.
Because the better part.
Oh, my gosh. I just came up with an idea.
Because the better part is, too, is, like, in your kitchen. Yeah. You can just, like,
You want to know what you could do with this?
Let me see here.
You could set up a game of deal or no deal with this. Because you know like they have the briefcase. So
yeah.
What you do is you pick the cabinet and you put one like this and then you put one inverted so it's upside down. And then you just put any sort of item in there.
Oh, that is upside down.
Where'd it go?
That is upside down.
Where'd it go?
I've got it over here.
Oh. Because what you do, yeah, is you put it like that.
Wait, is that the right way? Yeah, that is the right way.
Yeah, you do that. Or what you do is, you go like this.
Wow, that just all of a sudden got really hard to see those doors on it.
What you do is you do this, and then you do...
Yep, you just start sticking them on top of each other.
No, hold on. If you do
That could be a really long game, though. If you do a ton of those, and what is it? You pay so many, you get so many guesses. Whatever you get, you get.
Yeah.
And half of them are lumps of coal. What did you win? This giant lump of coal.
Well, let me go grab another piece of wood, and I'll show you what I mean.
All right, guys. Well, I think that is actually just about to do it for us today. We are reaching our time limit here. So, I'm going to head on off. Do you have even a piece of wood that's big enough? Just to throw it away? Okay. Well,
yes, I have a piece of wood that's big enough.
All right, we're grabbing this guy.
Because what you can do is you can make it so that these two cabinets go like this.
Mm-hmm. We'll just do this one real quick, and then we'll...
Just put the whole piece in.
Okay.
I don't care.
I was gonna say, I can get
what you do is
later.
That, and then say I want to put like a present in there. What you do is you can open all the doors, and then it slowly reveals the gift inside. And see, it's like a perfect storage.
I actually did not even think about sticking open end on open end. Here, let me get a good shot of this.
And that's the thing is too is they can't get in there to grab it. So like say. You have, like, a ton of stuff in there. They can't jump in that. It can just have the cross, and they can't walk in.
That is actually a pretty nice safe storage for some stuff.
So, like, if you have, like,
it's literally a cage for whatever you want to put inside of there. That is awesome.
Hold on, let me try with an axe. All
right. Well, we gotta go, guys. So, have a good one. Like, comment, subscribe, let me know what you think. Let me know what you think I should do again.
He's a really good person.
Some building with Bogla. Here we go. Have a good one, guys. See you later.